Greetings to all. Welcome to the official YouTube channel of SRN International School, Jaipur. Today, in this video, we are going to learn about the popular beliefs and religious debates of Class 7 Social Studies book. We shall study the development of the religious systems and cults in four stages. First is in the north from 800 to 1200 AD, in the south from AD 800 to 1200, under the Delhi Sultans AD 1206 to 1526, and under the Mughals from AD 1526 to 1707. First, we will study about the development of religious systems and cults in the north. The people during this period, especially the Rajputs, were mostly followers of Hinduism. This religion made great progress under them. Both the Shaiva and the Vaishnav sects were very popular in northern India. The people worshipped Vishnu, Shiva, Durga, and many other gods and goddesses of the Hindus. People belonging to Vaishnav sects came to believe in the legend of 10 incarnations of Vishnu. The Bhakti movement led by the Nainals and the Alwals in the south now spread to the north. It now became popular almost all over the country. The Bhakti saints disregarded caste inequalities and laid emphasis on the Vedas. Buddhism also witnessed revival. It was chiefly on account of the fact that Buddha came to be regarded as one of the incarnations of Vishnu. The worship of Buddha became more elaborate. Devotional songs, rites, and other ceremonies became a part of the Buddha worship. Jainism also gained popularity among the trading classes in the northwestern India. The colossal Jain image at Sarvan Belagola attests to the popularity of Jainism. The Jain doctrines of four gifts of learning, food, medicine, and shelter helped make Jainism more popular. Tantric sects and practices also spread among people during this period. These practices centered on prayers, certain formulas, and magical diagrams and symbols and worship of a particular deity. Development of religious systems and cults in the south. Mostly, the people followed Hinduism and worshipped the Hindu gods. Other religions like Buddhism and Jainism also existed. Christianity and Islam were also gaining followers. A number of religious movements started during this period. The Alawar and Nayanar saints continued to popularize their own sects. The Alawars popularized devotional songs of Vaishnavism, while the Nayanars sang hymns in praise of Shiva. We know much about the Alawar and Nayanar saints from their religious biographies, better known as hagiographies, which were composed by their followers. The Lingayats were the most popular of the religious sects. Some great religious teachers also lived during this period, and the best known among them were Shankaracharya and Ramanuja. Shankaracharya belonged to Kerala. He travelled all over India to teach the religious philosophy. He taught that knowledge was necessary for the worship of God, and it is called the Gyan Marg. He preached Religious monotheism or the system of Advaita, which means that God is unique. He established four maths or centers of Hindu culture in the four corners of India, namely Jyotirmath, Sharadapeeth, Govardhan Math, and Sringeri Math in the south. These maths have assumed great importance with the passage of time. Ramanuja was born around AD 1017 at Tirupati. He preached the Bhakti Mark. He emphasized the love and devotion were necessary for the worship of God. He regarded all human beings as equal. For him, no one was high or low. Every man could attain salvation by the true worship of God. Development of religious systems under the Delhi Sultans. With the Turkish rule, Islam also came to India. The main principles of Islam were, there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is his prophet. Muslims must pray five times a day. Muslims must give alms to the poor and needy. Muslims must observe fast during the holy month of Ramzan. Muslims must make a pilgrimage in Mecca at least once in a lifetime if they could afford. The pilgrimage is known as Hajj. The Mughals were the followers of Islam. Like their Turkish counterparts, they applied religious laws to the functioning of the government. Akbar, however, followed a liberal religious policy. He believed that every religion was basically good. He was influenced by the liberal ideas of the Sufi saints. He used to hold talks with the leaders of various religions and he got constructed a building called Ibadat Khana. Akbar constructed a building called Ibadat Khana, which is also known as the Hall of Worship, near Fatehpur Sikri, Agra, to hold discussions with the religious leaders. He opened the doors of Ibadat Khana to Hindus, Christians, Zoroastrians, and Jains. No single religion was allowed any kind of monopoly. During the religious discourses at Ibadat Khana, Akbar found that basically all religions taught similar things. He incorporated the principles of all the religions to found a new faith, which he named as Deen-e-Ilahi. Akbar's liberal religious views and his marriages with the Rajput princesses influenced his religious outlook. He used to hold talks with the leaders of various religions, and consequently, he found that basically all religions taught similar things. Thus, he incorporated the principles of all religions to found a new faith, which he named Deen-e-Ilahi. It was more a code of moral conduct than a religion, for it had no priest or rituals to perform. It was only the result of Akbar's firm belief that all religions point out towards one God. That is why he did not seek forced conversions to the new faith, which declared that Akbar was the spiritual guide of his people. It also discouraged killing of animals for food. Harsh punishments like mutilation of limbs was discontinued. It also disapproved sati, and according to this religion, the followers of Deen-e-Ilahi should be ready to sacrifice their property, their life, their honor, and their religion for their emperor. The word bhakti means devotion or love for God. Its teachings did not believe in caste distinction or class hatred. Its followers are divided into two groups. Those believing God having a form were known as Saguna, and those believing God as formless Nirguna. The followers of Saguna Bhakti worship their gods in different forms and in various incarnations. The followers of Nirguna Bhakti consider God as omnipresent and residing in every heart. Both types of followers had some common points. Both believed in Upanishadic philosophy or Advaita or non-duality of God. All the Bhakti saints laid great emphasis on attaining the knowledge from a guru. During the medieval period, the movement spread to the whole of India. Its basic principles were the following: a loving relationship between a devotee and his personal God, discarding of rituals and sacrifices as modes of worship, purity of heart and mind and kindness, discarding of any discrimination based on gender, caste or creed, brotherhood of mankind. The Bhakti movement in India is responsible for many changes introduced in the worship of God by Hindus, Muslims and Sikhs of Indian subcontinent. For example, Kirtan at Hindu temple, Qawwali at a Darga and singing of Gurbani at a Gurudwara are all derived from the. Some of the important Bhakti saints were Ramanuja, Ramananda, Kabir, Namdev, Guru Nanak, Vallabhacharya, Chaitanya and Mirabai. Ramanuja was born in a town near Madras, which is now known as Chennai. He preached the worship of Lord Vishnu. He had won many followers in South India. Ramananda was born at Allahabad in a Brahmin family. He was the first reformer to preach in Hindi, and he had many disciples, one of whom was Kabir. Kabir was the most popular reformer of Bhakti movement. He was a weaver by profession. He had firm faith in Hindu-Muslim unity, and thousands of his disciples came from both the communities. He believed in Nirguna form of Bhakti. He was a famous disciple of Ramananda, and his couplets or dohas are still recited everywhere in India. Mirabai was a Rathore princess. She was married to Rana Sangha's eldest son, Bhojraj. From her childhood, she was a great devotee of Krishna. Her devotional songs are very popular even today. She contributed a lot in popularizing the Bhakti movement. Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism. He was born in 1469 at Talwandi, which is now called Nankana Sahib, and it is now in Pakistan. The teachings and deeds of the 10 gurus form the basic message of Sikhism. Most of these are found in the form of hymns and songs in ragas collected in a book called Adi Grantha, which is the sacred book of Sikhism. The main teachings of Sikhism or of Guru Nanak form the basic principles of Sikhism. According to him, God is one. He is the creator of the universe. God is truth. Class distinctions are useless because they divide human beings. He believed in good actions and true devotion. He denounced useless rituals which were prevalent at that time. To bring caste together, he decided and insisted that his followers should dine together at the langar or community kitchen. Like Kabir, he also denounced useless rituals both of the Hindus and the Muslims. He did not believe in renouncing the world. He said that household stage is superior to all the stages. There are 10 gurus of the Sikhs. First, Guru Nanak. Second, Guru Angad. Third, Guru Amrit Dev. Fourth, Guru Ramdas. Fifth, Guru Arjan. Sixth, Guru Har Gobind. Seventh, Guru Har Rai. Eighth, Guru Har Kishan. Ninth, Guru Tegh Bahadur. And the last Guru was Guru Gobind Singh, who founded the Khalsa Panth in AD 1699. So children, this is all about the topic. And if you like it, don't forget to like the channel and subscribe it. Thank you. God bless you all.